school and education, it's really part of the capitalist machine. It's a very, very crucial part. Kind of exploitation of students that was there to begin with is now being escalated. Not only students are being exploited because the work that they do is preparation. They're preparing themselves to become workers for capital. But they are also, in addition, exploited as unpaid labor. So the amount of unpaid labor the students now have to do before, you know, reaching a certificate is continuously expanding. Now we know that there are entire companies who are laying off workers because they know they are going to have a student's internship. The whole system of internship is a machine for the production of unpaid labor. Schooling is training into us becoming future workers. It's training for exploitation. And so why do we have to pay for our training? Students are also producers of knowledge, are not passive recipients. They are producers of knowledge and they are future producers, future workers. Therefore, the state should pay, the capitalist class should pay for it. Once we begin to look at the issue of unpaid labor, once we begin to see that unpaid labor is what fuels, is the fuel of capitalist exploitation, once we look at capitalism from that point of view, the viewpoint of the wageless, with the anti-colonial struggle, the Black Power movement, and the women's movement, then we see, then the question of intersectionality is very clear. I think that the best expression of an intersectional position is to recognize that there are hierarchies, that the capitalist class has built hierarchies within the global proletariat. And you don't overcome those hierarchies by, you know, slogans. Those hierarchies are overcome by a whole process of connection that recognizes the right to organizational autonomy.